Hi, this is Sean. In this video, I'm going to go over how to get 3D objects into Aurasma. So, there's quite a few little pieces of this workflow. So I'm just going to start from having built a 3D object. And Aurasma can take multiple objects. It does prefer to have one texture per object. It can actually take several different types of shading models, with Lambert being the least troublesome for it, but it can take Phong and Blinn as well. It also wants to be lit, so it can use bump maps, and or at least normal maps, and also incandescent maps, but it likes... you can send over the point lights with the model. One odd thing is that the it says in the documentation that it's really not the intensity that will get sent over with the light, but the color, the sort of luminance value. So if you want to like have 0.5 lit, 0.5 lit on different sides, and they suggest like a 3-point lighting model. So there you go. I'm going to do two lights. And then I'm going to send this over as a DAE. It's a Collada file type. But before I do that, you want to triangulate your models. Most real-time software requires triangulated models. So under Mesh, Triangulate. Okay, we've got that all set up. And then also you can animate. You can send over animations with Aurasma too. So I'm going to just center this pivot and set a keyframe on the rotation and just rotate this. Let's see, we've got it 360 degrees. So there we go. I've rotated that. And now I'm going to export all. File, export all, and I'm going to save this as a DAE underscore FBX file type to my desktop, and I'm going to call this building a R. Okay, so let's look at the other things that I've got on the desktop saved out. Here's where we're going to export to, the Aurasma Studio. I'm going to use this image as a trigger. I've got the file texture. That I'm using, it needs to be in a power of 2. So in this case, it's a 1024 by 1024, but 512 by 512 would work. Also, the engine supports UV overlapping and tiling, so that's nice. And also, there's this thumbnail. So this is a PNG. I used just they had a PNG example of the thumbnail. So I just kept it at the same width and height, 728 by 728. Okay. So, and it seems that Aurasma can also support a transparency, so you could use a PNG as your file type as well if you wanted transparencies, but transparencies are a little bit more processor intensive, so be careful. Okay, so I've got my DAE file, and really it's these three files that I need, so I'm going to control click and right click, and using 7-zip I'm going to add those to an archive. And the specific kind of archive that the Aurasma engine wants is a TAR. So I'll call this and give it an appropriate name. So building TAR, hit OK. And so now I've got this building TAR image. So let's go to the Aurasma webpage, and just in terms of where to get more information, under Advanced Topics, 3D Models for Overlays. And an overlay is the content item that you're going to be bringing in. So this is the sheet to read. There's a bunch of rules of thumb, 10,000 triangles, where you should put it in the origin. One of the things that I didn't do correctly in this demo is I should have baked out the animation keyframes on this thing. So you can do that really easily under Edit, Keys, Bake Simulation, and that'll throw a keyframe on every single frame here. Let's just kick this out again, export all, and replace that. And let's get rid of this tar file and resend that to a 7. Add to archive. Building. So this is the sheet to read here in terms of like what you can use. And it accepts bone driven animation as well, but it doesn't seem, I did a quick test, it doesn't seem to do vertex driven animation. So like I try to do a morph, which is, the data is held, keyframes are held in the morphs, vertices, so that didn't seem to work. Anyhow, so then when you're done with that, the way to test to make sure that it will work as an asset in Aurasma is to load it into the Aurasma as an overlay. So I'm going to say add, we'll do a 3D building is the name, and I'm going to choose 3D model and just find it from, so this is building tar file, and hit open and then just save it. And so if it doesn't throw any errors, then you've got, you're good to go pretty much. So, and it looks like, looks like we're fine. So wonderful. And here's the building. We could even test that in a using it in an aura. So the aura that I had sort of set up to test this was here. Here's the trigger image that I had chosen. This happy 1950s looking trigger image. And let's so that was called like 3D building. And so there it is. And if I hold down the Z key, I can sort of move that in respect to the trigger. I mean, I could sort of, there's a bunch of, if you hold down H, you can get a bunch of different. So I'm going to hit so you can hit E to toggle the animation because that was getting annoying. But H will give you a list of commands for placing this so that it shows up in respect to your trigger image. So that's pretty much it. I mean, there's a bunch of other things that you can do in terms of setting up your animation. We've got different, you can have different overlays that happen. And there's other actions that you can apply when an overlay is tapped. And you can delete those. So that's pretty much it for now. Thanks so much for watching.